My dear friends, my dear faithful, it's Friday. It's not just ordinary Friday. It's a good Friday. The Friday that liberated the world. The Friday that transformed the world. The Friday that united the world in the love of Christ. As we are contemplating on this Holy Triduum, let us reflect on the day. Try to draw some blessings from this day. Let us share the look of Jesus, the look of our Christ. Two men were facing each other. One is a couple of hours away from death. Though totally innocent he was, but because of betrayal, he is going to face the death. And the other person has just denied that very close friend of his. That person denied Jesus not because he hated Jesus. No, he loved Jesus. He left his family. He left his dear and near ones. And he went out. He followed Christ because he loved Jesus. If he loved Jesus so much, then why did he deny Jesus? Because he fell in the company of bad people. He felt himself secure among those bad company, bad people, which forced him to deny Jesus. Judas betrayed Jesus, not because he hated Jesus, no. He loved Jesus so much that he had left his family. He had left his near and dear ones, and he had followed Christ totally because he loved Jesus. And that we see again a couple of incidents in the gospel. He was the treasurer. Now you tell me, who entrusts money to whom? The person whom we trust the most. Judas was handling the finance. He was a finance minister of Jesus. He was given the treasure of the company to Judas because he was the most trusted person. But you know what happened? He fell in love. He fell in love with the gift. The financial responsibility was given to him, but he fell in love with that money. And that led him astray from Jesus. Do you think he was going to become a very rich person with these 30 silver coins? No, we know later on he even returns that 30 silver coin. And it is mentioned, Judas sold Jesus. Judas sold God for 30 silver coin. I wonder, God was out for sale for 30 silver coin? Who can sell God for 30 silver coin? Can God be sold? No. Judas did not sell God. Judas sold himself. He made his worth 30 silver coin. Judas sold his trust. His trust was so cheap, could be bought by 30 silver coin. Judas sold his love for 30 silver coin. Judas sold his friendship for 30 silver coin. Judas sold himself. Who could sell God for 30 silver coin? Judas sold himself. He sold his hope, his faith, his trust, His love, His friendship. You know what? The kiss of Judas was more painful than the nails on the cross, because there he had sold his friendship to those, the enemies. 30 silver coin, and then he realized, he came home to himself, he became aware what the grave mistake he had done. Just for 30 silver coin, he had lost the best friend in his life. The friend of Jesus, the person of Jesus, he had lost. He realized that. And then he thought the worthless of the value of money is nothing compared to the person of Christ. He realized and he threw that money away. My dear friends, my dear people, don't we often do these things? Aren't we trusted and entrusted different responsibilities in our lives? The responsibility of a husband. Who is given this responsibility of a husband? The one who is trusted and could be entrusted a wife to a husband. Who could be trusted and entrusted? The one who is given husband to his wife. Who is the most trusted? Who are entrusted parents to their children. Who is more trusted? The workers in the company. The boss of the company entrusts the entire company in the hand of a person because he trusts. He trusts the person and entrusts the gifts to him. We are, every responsibility given to us is the trust that is somebody showing towards us. Am I selling that trust for fringe benefits? Am I at times selling trust of my principal as a teacher? Am I selling that trust to my teacher as a student? For small little benefits in life, there is where often I also act like that of Judas. Am I betraying my husband for little benefits outside? Am I betraying my wife? Am I betraying my parents for little enjoyment outside? Am I betraying my children for little pleasures of life? My dear, with little pleasure, we lose the person. For Judas, it was little late. But it is said, better late than never. He threw away the money that took him away from Jesus. But he made one grave mistake. He turned himself from the wickedness but failed to face that light. I am having a question in my mind. If Judas was in love with money, the money that he valued the most, the company of high society people he valued so much, now he had money with him. He was in the company of the top people of the community, the Jewish community. He should have been happy. He should have been celebrating life. But no, he gives it up. My question is, if he had all the money with him, if he had the best company of Jewish community, then why did he commit suicide? What led him to commit suicide is only one thing. He gave up everything but failed to go to Jesus. He failed to see Jesus. He failed to look at Jesus. That one gaze of Jesus would have saved his life. Just one look of Jesus would have saved him and transformed him. My dear friends, this is what the invitation during this Holy Week, especially today as we are contemplating on crucified Christ. One look, one gaze at Jesus, rather, one gaze of Jesus will transform my heart. His one look is enough to make me a new person. Judas failed to look at Jesus. All the suffering, all the pain, all the crisis where we experience in life is often because we failed to look at the cross, the crucified Christ. If we look at him, we will not be so much affected by the crisis, the problem, the suffering, the sickness in our lives. Because it is the look of Christ will transform all this. Coronavirus is not bigger than my cross, my Jesus. My Jesus is much more bigger. David and Goliath. Everybody looked at Goliath and were afraid because they found the problem was bigger. But David came and looked at God and said, "How small is my problem? How big is my God?" While we are in this crisis of Corona, are we so much concentrating on Corona? Then we will be afraid, we'll be frightened. And fear is the weapon of wicked. Fear is the weapon of devil. Fear that breaks us. Fear that finishes us. But the look of Jesus gives us courage and strength to stand against any difficult life that we have. And not all, not Judas, there was someone who faced Jesus and was transformed. That Samaritan woman faced Jesus and transformed for life. Zacchaeus faced Jesus and was transformed for his life. That Peter who denied Jesus because of the company, because he did not want to lose the bad company he was into. He found security there. But the look of Jesus transformed him. There are so many of them looked at Jesus and were transformed. It is the invitation for you and for me. If we, in our crisis time, in our difficult time, in the time of sickness, in the time of pain, in the time of suffering, there is only one invitation for each one of us. We need to look at Jesus. Today we have an invitation. Jesus is asking us, look at me, because we are believing not God. We are believing in the God who is crucified. Our God, the God who is crucified God, and we are his disciples. Our way is a way of crucifixion, and that is going to transform us. That is going to make us a new person. And to become Christ, we need the love within our hearts. The love that transformed prodigal son, the love that transformed Zacchaeus, the love that transformed Matthew, the love that transformed a Samaritan woman. Jesus today, on this day, looking for us under the cross. Let us be with Christ. Let us be with him under the cross. And then he will look at us and say, "You are my beloved disciple, in whom I am well pleased." He will entrust his responsibility to each one of us. As he did that from the cross to that beloved disciple, he entrusted his mother. Today he wants to entrust once again a woman as a wife in my life, a husband as a responsibility in my life. But if we are with Jesus, we will accept this responsibility and transform this responsibility into a renewed love, a living love in our lives. As we are in this season, in this holy Triduum, let's ask the Lord. Let's ask the Lord that He may touch our hearts. Not just see our external appearances, but transform our hearts. How do I want to respond to His love? The total love of Jesus. The total loving of Jesus. That we may be transformed in our hearts. That we may find that true love with our family, in our family. It is the look of Jesus will make us a new person. Wishing you all a very happy Holy Triduum journey with Jesus towards the Passion, towards the cross. Amen. May God bless you all.